Good morning, children. Today we are going to see the book inside 1 marks. Okay, ma. First one in the first lesson. This is our first 1 mark. Okay. Then that is the term software was first used by John W. Tukey. Then we have the example. What is the example for a system software? Now operating system is an example for system software. Okay, ma. Then. You have to know all these dark words. We are already using this in our answers, so I am not giving it explicitly. Okay. The third one, who is called the father of Pentium? Vinod Dam is called as the father of Pentium. Third one. Okay. Now coming to the fourth one. Fourth one is here in page number 7. What is VisiCalc? VisiCalc was the first computer spreadsheet program. Then what is the fifth one? The expansion for DBMS, database management system. So the expansion you should know. Then coming to the as of now only we will be having 5 book inside questions. Apart from this, you should know the examples for the graphic software, Paint, Photoshop, all this, because that can be asked in match the following. Okay. And this example for database, then the example for the spreadsheet, then the examples for your Microsoft Word, that word processing software, all these examples you should be knowing. And for the desktop publishing package, you should know the CorelDRAW, PageMaker, etc. Okay. Also, for this desktop publishing package, you can write at the bracket DTP. Okay, desktop publishing package. Okay, that was DBMS expansion is database management system, and for DTP the expansion is desktop publishing. Okay, then the presentation software you can take PowerPoint, Flash, etc. These examples you should know. Okay, now coming to the lesson number 2. First question is. Or the first 1 mark is the data in our computer is organized in the form of files and folders. Okay. Then the second 1 mark would be a folder within a folder is called as subfolder. Then the third one would be in MS Office the width of the file extension is what? 4 characters. That is .xlsx. Okay. .xlsx. You will having 4 characters for this extension. So there will be the third one. Fourth one is what is a library, which is a kind of a folder used to manage documents, pictures, everything. This is also there. Then the fifth one, how are we going to locate the files and folders? It is using the documents folder or the Windows Explorer folder. This will be the fifth one. Okay. Then you should know how many panes are there, which is the left pane and the right pane. Left pane will display the disk drives. This is important. And in the right pane, what will we having? Displays the contents. These two are also important. Then coming to our next 1 mark, you should be having it here. Control panel is a system folder. This should be very, very important. And then as of this lesson, you will be only having this. Others are all there in the book bag 1 mark itself. Okay. Then coming to the third lesson. What are we going to do in the third lesson? The third lesson, 1 marks. You can read it from the first one is from here. That is how we are going to create the shortcut for MS Excel from the start menu. Okay. Then the second one, the tab scrolling buttons to the left of the sheet tabs let you move through the tabs quickly. So what are the buttons which help you to move through the tabs quickly is the tab scrolling button. So this will be the fill-ups. Then what are the 3 types of data entered? The numbers, text and formula. If it is not in the question answers, you should know this. Okay. Then the highlighted box is called the cell pointer. Okay. Then the number of default books. The number of default books is 3. By default, 3 worksheets. Okay. Then you should know the number of rows and columns, because that is already there in the book back one mark. You should also know that for match everything. Then, apart from this, you will be having column headings. Starts from letter A to Z, AA to AZ, up to XFD. AA to through AZ and up to XFD. So totally you have 16,384 columns. Then coming to the sheet tabs. So what is the sheet tabs? It will be appearing in the sheet in the status bar. Okay. Then you will be having three sheets we already discussed. Then and the shortcut keys you should know. This can be asked in one mark also. Then we will be having this portion as the fourth question. You can save the workbook by clicking on the office button and selecting the save option, or this is first point. Second one is the save button or save as dialog box. All these three things can come together. Okay, so this is also there. Then this is your fifth one. Merge and center button lets you to place the content. So this is very, very important. This is your sixth one. By default, the text is aligned to the left and the numbers are aligned to the right. The shortcut key for saving, Control plus S. Then average function. What is this average function? It is a function which will be find the average. Find average. Okay. To find average, we use the average function. Autosum. Autosum, you'll be adding, or it will be adding all the things and giving the answer key. Okay. Now, the formula will always start with an equal to sign. You should know this. Okay. Then coming to the fourth lesson. What is our fourth lesson? Editing a worksheet. So first one, we are going to see MS Excel is an application software. Okay. This is one mark. Okay. DAS is an application software. And then to repeat the actions, we have to press F4 key. To repeat the actions, we have to press the F4 key. Then for entering the time and date, okay, you have to see the date or time in the category. And then there is also an apostrophe. This is a book back question, so we are not bothered there. Then this will be your second most of them. That is to use the default date or time format. We have to click on the cell that contains and press Control plus Shift plus. This is also important, one mark. Then to edit, okay, we can use F2 key. That is, this is your third one mark, okay. Then we can use the redo and undo shortcut keys. Control plus Z and Control plus Y are the redo and the shortcut keys. Then to copy and move data, we can use what? Control plus C, Control plus V. Okay, that is your cut and edit options. Cut and edit option. Cut means Control plus X, paste means Control plus V. Okay, then Control plus C means it is copying. Control plus C means copying. Then escape key to remove the moving border. Escape key to remove the moving border. Then autofill, that is how we are going to use here. When the two consecutive numbers are typed, then you get the autofill feature. Otherwise, if it is a text, okay, it copies the data in the source cell to the destination cells. Okay, so all this you should be knowing apart from the book back one marks. Okay, as of now we will be going through all this for your exams. So for the exams you will be having one marks. You already know from the last year's computer pattern itself. We'll be having fill ups, match, choose, one word, all this. So for that you have to know, you have to learn from all this book inside questions also. Okay, so only I am giving a separate video for this apart from the ones which I gave in the earlier class. Those videos were only for the book back. Now this is all in the book inside. If you all have any doubts, you can ask me, message me, and then you should learn for your exam. Okay, children. Thank you.